This the chopper power. 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 This the chopper power.
Yeah. I'm Fat Man, and this is the chopper hour. That's what I'm talking about. You heard what she said, Nickel? Hey, T-Baby, I got the magnificent T-Baby.
Magnificent.
Thank you for pulling up, man. I've been looking forward to this.
Yeah, how long?
Oh, man, how many months? It's been quite a bit of months, but we're here now.
Yeah,
but we're here now. So, you know, everything happens on some time. It is, exactly. Man, how you doing today?
Good.
You good? Looking good. Man, look, I ain't knew you was going to come all dolled up, but it's the best way to be if you're going to be on camera.
I was
going to
be a little more dolled up. You were? Have to make a stop.
Hey.
I was going to be.
You look good to be there.
I had a whole other wig I was putting on.
Hey, do your thing. Hey, man, I always tell artists, man, you want to look your best, man, because first impression is the best, you know, the impression that you want. You know what I mean? Everybody going to have, some people have down days. This is not understand, but when you do shit like this, you represent yourself and your brand.
I was kind of mad, but I'm trying to look at it on the good side. I was like, this is what comes with it. You don't have to get, like, ready faster. So my 2 hours that I had to get ready cut down to, like, 15 minutes.
Get the fuck out of here. You able to do it?
Yeah.
Oh,
I was like, I'm just put this wig on, this wig. Just clip on.
You must lay shit out before the day before. You lay it out the day before?
Nah, I was going to wear something else and everything. I was like, damn. I'm doing the basic, the leather.
Yeah, it always works, trust me. It always fucking works. Man, T-Baby, man. Well, it was also what, Dream Goddess? Or was it Dream Goddess and T-Baby? Which one is it? It's both.
Dream Goddess and T-Baby.
Okay.
Like, Magnificent is directly.
Okay.
And Dream Goddess is my spiritual with my gifts. How I, like, speak to the world.
Okay.
They the one, because I talk to Dream Goddess. Not that I'm crazy, that I have two different personalities.
Right.
But I talk to Dream Goddess on music to say shit differently. More like, I don't know, Magnificent, more rowdy, like, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And Dream Goddess is more like spiritual and like calm with it.
So like your alter ego.
Yeah.
Sweet. I like that, man. A lot of people don't speak on that a lot. I don't know. Well, I think Beyonce, I remember I was on stuff like that one time. But, that's pretty cool that way. So let me ask you, when you go into the studio to create, is sometimes we dealing with Dream Goddess and then sometimes we dealing with Magnificent T-Baby?
Exactly.
That's how it works.
Yeah. Ooh. As I'm writing, I was like, come on Dream, what you got to say? You take this one on. Or I just be sitting there, like my song Witches that just came out. I was just sitting on the couch one day and I was watching Game of Thrones.
Love that show.
I was just sitting there like this here. And I had the beat, but I ain't had the lyrics.
Okay.
And then all of a sudden, lyrics started coming in my head. I started, like, typing in my phone because I couldn't even go get my pencil.
Right, right.
And I wrote the whole song, Witches, right now, 15 minutes, wow. Not even.
Wow, Witches.
Yeah.
And that was coming from Dream Goddess.
Yeah.
Mm, you recorded the song already?
Yeah. I just put it out on my birthday.
Okay. I wrote that down too, actually, matter of fact. There's a couple of records I wanted to ask you about, man. So Dream Goddess, that's more conscious.
Yeah.
T-Baby Ratchet more.
Third eye
topic. Okay. Mm-hmm. So T-Baby more on the sexual ratchetness a little bit. Love it.
Thug
die. Yeah, all of that shit, man. All of that shit. Would you mixing a lot of your sexuality into the records, especially the visuals?
Yeah.
Your visuals are amazing. I gotta say, man, I enjoyed all your videos that
I've
looked
at.
Shout out the boss
Shout
up.
Out T-Precious.
My nigga.
Mills.
What I'm talking about, man. I see. Mills he bring them to life, though. He done brought a lot of your shit to life, man.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
Did you get that? You just spoke about the show just now. You was watching with your little soap. What the show you just spoke about?
Game of Thrones.
Did you get that costume idea from
I got,
that?
Maleficent. Where I got my name too from. Maleficent.
It all ties in now.
Yeah.
I said that when I saw the horns. I said that. I said she got that from something.
Yeah.
Hey, that's dope.
I love that movie. And I actually supposed to send Chuck to put in something I typed up.
Okay.
I copied it and pasted it and turned it around into myself from the movie. When they tell you like the about the movie before they put it out, mm-hmm. they tell you, you know, whatever that shit called.
Right, the captions and shit.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I just changed it to myself, and I forgot to send Chuck it to put in the beginning of the movie.
Right.
Because that's just where I'm at. I'm here for revenge, like, type shit. Okay. Because been trying to do this
thing. That's what's up, though. You're doing it now, though. I'm telling you right now, man. Y'all sleep if y'all ain't tapped in to Team Mike Simpson. Y'all sleeping. Y'all ain't a founder yet, man. She dope as fuck, man. I don't want to get ahead of myself, T-Baby. But I got to ask you, where you from originally?
Liberia.
Me too.
Sims Creek.
Like I didn't know this shit. Me too. That's my hood, too. Born and raised, man. We probably know a lot of the same people, too.
Yeah.
I'm sure, man.
My mama made me a little house girl, so she ain't...
You went outside?
Mama, yeah, she was very protective of my energy. Like, she ain't really let me outside.
Right, right. Just because you from an environment don't mean you are the environment.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what's up, man. Well, let me ask you, how long you been... what got you into music originally?
I always liked music since I was like 10. But I started February.
Not out. This February just passed, no.
This year, February.
This year, February?
2022.
Get the fuck out of here. Yeah. I would have never thought that, man.
Yeah.
You do it so professional, man. It's just hard for me
people
to
people say that. And the guy told me on the phone, this man, he told me, he said, stop telling people that. Stop telling people you just started doing music. Mm-hmm. Stop trying not to tell people.
Yeah.
You don't sound like you just started.
You don't. You don't.
And don't tell people you just started. Because you just started, they gonna make you do things a certain way. They won't want you to start from where they started at.
Of course.
And that's not what I'm here to do.
And all of that, they'll marginalize you.
Yeah.
They're like, oh, she new to this. She don't know much. She don't know this and that. So, you know what I mean? Counting bars and all that kind of wild stuff, you know?
Yeah. I don't know how to count bars.
Well, you doing it.
But they don't know how it's supposed to.
You doing it and you don't even know it.
Yeah.
You doing it. You doing it now. You just don't understand how it works, but you're doing it right now. The click, click, click.
Yeah.
Click, click. Them your bars.
Yeah. It's just like, when it's for you, it just
naturally, right?
Naturally.
Yeah. I like it, man. Damn. So you say February, which I don't want to bring up again, but your visuals are amazing. I want to ask you about this. Is this song called Online Freak when you said the words two fingers in a small space? Is that the song Online Freaks?
No, that's not Holly Freaks.
That's Holly Freaks.
No, that's Hellbroke.
Hellbroke. I was looking for the name of the song. I was looking. I said, well, I said, maybe if I bring up the word two fingers in a small space. What inspired that record?
Well, I was actually doing that to another song. That song was actually, verse was actually with Why You Hate Me.
Okay.
And I changed the beat. Because I was speaking Korean, so I had a Korean beat. But I told somebody about it. And sometimes when I tell somebody about something I'm doing, I feel like they, like, mentally they gonna mess it up. You
right.
know what I'm saying? So I said, you know what, I'm gonna switch the whole scenario because I shouldn't have told you that before I did it.
Right.
So I split the lyrics up.
Okay.
And then Hell Broke was, I was talking to some guy and I was just like, he pissed me off. He's also in the Holly Freaks. So he inspired that whole song. And then I had the second verse before the first verse, which is the verse you're talking about.
Okay.
And so I was just like, just sitting there. I don't even know where my lyrics come from half of the time. I'll be like, feel like I'm zoned out.
Is there a certain time that you get inspired to write records, or it could come anytime? Is it mid, late night? A lot of people write at night.
I feel like it's certain times. I don't know, my body just works a certain way. Like, throughout a certain week, that week of each month, I can write whatever.
Oh,
and then
wow.
1 week out of the month, it's just like, it's my relax time. And I just go over my lyrics. So by the time I end up going to the studio, I know my lyrics by heart.
Okay.
Because that's my rest period.
Okay.
And I'm like with Dream Goddess at this time. And then the other times, like, say, like, around full moons, like, I'm more like, illuminated and shit just come to me like crazy.
Gotcha.
Ideas out, like. But yeah, that just, I was fucking with this
first
girl and everything. And I was just,
wow.
I was thinking about her at the same time.
Wow. Dope record, man. Dope fucking record.
I honestly wrote that on my way to the studio. Like, like, I wrote that shit, and I was like, I can't remember.
You end up laying it that same day?
Yeah, the man told me you have to do 2 hours at the studio. I was like, let me just get an hour, and I only got to do no chorus. So I was like, I only got, like, you know what I'm saying, one song to do. Can I get an hour? He's like, it's 2 hours minimum.
Right.
Like, oh, damn, what am I coming in with now?
Yeah.
I said, fuck it. I woke up that morning, I was like, dropped my kids off to school, came back home. I wrote it, and I had to be
at
the studio within an hour, and I wrote that shit.
Wrote that shit. Dope record. Ain't you glad you did?
That was my favorite record, but everybody was like, dropping No Chorus. So I did what the people wanted, but I actually, and they wanted a video for No Chorus. And I was like, how y'all want a video for No Chorus? And even Chuck was like, I see all the visuals you can do for help that one.
Right.
And I was like, they want No Chorus.
Right.
I was like, fuck yeah, and No Chorus is just playing in the, I'm like, I ain't finna do all that shit to No Chorus. That's too many parts.
Yeah.
I was like,
fuck that shit. Man, you a dope ass artist, man. No Chorus, that record there. Did it set out the path, No Chorus, or are you already, you wrote it as soul, or you originally had a chorus for it?
All my lyrics literally have like a back story to it. No Chorus is actually a feature.
Okay.
And the guy was like, I don't know, me, when you send me, you tell me you want a feature from me, send me the beat, I have your feature in like 30 minutes to an hour, okay. No cap. And he was like, he's like, oh, I'm gonna pay for everything, blah, blah, blah. And then he said, oh, well, you just go record at your studio and you have it mixed and mastered. I'm like, shit, one person can mix and master on a song.
Right.
And that's too much. We wasting money.
Exactly.
And then you know, he just was doing too much talking. And I was like, you know what? Fuck it. I just started adding to the lyrics to make it even longer. And then in the beat, I don't know how to count bars.
Right.
So in certain beats, it's like, what do I put the chorus in?
Right.
I didn't know.
Right.
So I just kept going.
Just kept going. That's what
I
do.
Fuck it. We ain't got no chorus. And I just, like, chorus is just hard for me to do sometimes. Like,
really?
Yeah.
It's like a hook, right? So many words.
Yeah. But some people, I was, you know, doing my reading up and stuff, some people write their chorus before they write their lyrics.
Most people do. But a lot of people do. I don't know if you noticed, but a lot of people will take a verse or a couple bars out of a verse and make a hook out of that. And Tupac was big on that.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's something to think about in the future when you get back in the studio again. Like, man, I don't know what I got a hook. Okay, I can take this part out of there and did it. You know what I mean?
Just them choruses before my mind.
You're a dope fucking artist, man. Your visuals.
I actually let the chorus come to me.
Okay.
I feel like the beat talked to you a little bit.
Yeah, right.
I don't know if I sound crazy.
No doubt about it. It's tribal.
Sometimes the beat just talked to you.
It's tribal.
Like with Witches, the beat actually said that it wanted to save my chorus part.
Right.
Part I was singing. It said that to me, so I just...
There it is. You're speaking on some deep shit right now. I'm going down a rabbit hole. Because think about it. When tribes had drums and I'm sure you done seen old footage of like tribe people that lived in the woods and stuff like they be dancing and shouting and beating on little shit, shaking leaves and all kind of weird shit.
That's my ancestors.
And it's tribal. That's tribal stuff. So I think we had a connection with music way before...
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It was something about the sound, the tempo, the rhythm.
I listen to music like that.
Yes.
So
it's important. Are you hands-on when your track's being made, the music part of it? Are you like to be hands-on or you'll just take a track with your own project, not other people's? You like cooking with the producer at that moment?
I've never cooked with a producer yet.
Okay, you done
that? I get all my beats from like YouTube.
Okay,
like
I got you.
Or like United Masters, they be having
Okay, that's good to know.
My engineer, we got a few beats that I want to make, so.
Okay. You can get your feet wet.
Yeah.
A little bit in that area.
Connect more with the
engineer. Yeah, that side of the game.
I just can't see myself recording with nobody else.
Right. who you produce with?
I'm just saying. His name is Mighty.
Mighty?
Yeah.
Okay.
I can't even think of his name.
It's Instagram. All good. I'm sure he'll know.
They in Pompano.
Okay.
The SK or something like that.
Okay.
What Kodak recorded on. Gremlins.
Okay, that same place?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
What's that song called?
I don't know.
We Could Have Been Superstars.
That thing's Gremlins. Super Gremlins.
Yeah, Super Gremlins. Whatever he recorded that at. Oh, that Pompano. Great studio. I love him.
Okay. Man, shout out to, I know a few guys. I had a few of them guys on here. Snow. Shout out to Snow. And shout out to Dirty 1000. Dope artists as well.
I'm trying to record at other places.
Too, and shooters, too. Fuck with shooters, too. Man, hey, that's fucking amazing. That's good stuff to know. And then since you was talking about that, about, like, artists that did songs at studios like that, I was watching this thing one time where it was a studio, I don't know if it's New York or California somewhere, and they say they never changed it. Hit people made records there like James Brown, Lenny Kravitz, man, they had a bunch of legendary artists that Barry White, guys that recorded in this place, and they never changed it.
Yeah.
They left it the same way it is. And the guy say, when my opportunity came to record a song there, he said, when I walked in that door, he said, man, I can't even tell you. Most of the artists that recorded are dead and gone. But he said it was some type of energy in that room. Like, he felt it immediately when he walked in there. He said some people had signatures on the wall that they had been there in the dates and times and shit like that. But the owner of the studio never changed it. They changed the equipment that they used, because, you know, they're cool with better stuff these days.
Yeah.
But the layout and the furniture, all of it the same.
Yeah.
And, man, he said it was powerful walking into that place.
So I asked God for a new studio, because while I was recording there, I asked God, I was like, God, I need a new studio. I got two songs that I want to record. I need a new studio. And I went to perform, and this guy walked up on me, and he was like, he from like 808 Mafia.
Okay, I heard it.
He had walked up on me, and he had these bifocals on. I'm like, this nigga, I love the weird shit.
Yeah.
I love people who just look weird.
Okay.
And he had these bifocals on. I'm like, and he was like, oh, he got a studio in Pompano, and he gonna send me the information, you know. I was like, bet. So I went to the studio. I met the guy. I actually thought it was gonna be him recording me, because I, you know what I'm saying, I didn't know. But the guy opened up, his name Mighty. And I was like, when I sent him my money, his number said 222. And that whole week, I kept seeing 222. I was like, this my engineer.
Yeah, it is.
I can't switch.
Say
it.
No more. And you had all that
God. Even if I'm recording that in another state when I blow, I'm calling Mighty. I was like, hey, what's
up? Come on. Get in the plane. Let's go. I want you. Man, hey man, see, you speaking about stuff coming to fruition. You say you asked God about that.
Yes.
A new recording spot.
Somebody actually walked up to me and told me to come record that.
Wow, a beautiful person to understand. How many records you done did with this guy?
All my other songs.
All your other songs.
Only did like four songs with somebody else, but everything else is with Mighty.
Wow. And all your visuals been with Bossed Up Chuck. Dope shit.
And ain't switching that up either.
That's
the type of
you got you. That's your chemistry. That's what it is.
Once we locked in, we locked in for life.
That's what's up.
And you can help me grow, I'm helping you grow.
That's what it's about.
You know?
And you helping me grow. Yeah. Thank you, man.
You helping me grow.
You're going to look back at this video like, man, I remember that,
you
man.
You're going to be at the top looking at
it. Yeah,
like,
looking
man,
like it started there. That's how this shit go, man. Nobody did it by themselves, T-Baby. Nobody. I don't care who told who. The story, you sometimes hear the story like, when you hear niggas saying rap songs, ain't nobody gave me nothing. Somebody gave you something, though. Whether you want to acknowledge it or not.
Yeah.
Well, you ain't, might not even be cool with that individual no more.
Yeah.
But you got to give them the you got to give them the props, because they gave you an opportunity, which one of some people did. So I don't pay that no attention when niggas say they did it by themselves.
Yeah.
They grow by themselves. So it is what it freaking is, man.
I'm still looking for my family out there.
Straight up. What family?
My music family.
Okay, you still searching?
Like,
that's what's up, though. That's what's up. It's growth, though. It's levels in this thing, man.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? I see a lot of your visuals dark, man.
Yeah.
You like dark?
Yeah.
The jeans, the pants made me say that.
Rockstar.
You like that?
Yeah.
The boots and shit.
Emo type shit.
All that type of shit.
Yeah.
Shit.
My little sister, 100% emo. I'm 50%. She
100%. 50%?
My sister hairbanging emo.
Where did that
I
come from?
I got her on that.
Oh, you got it? You started her with it?
I don't know. Like, my family thought I was weird because I used to wear black nails and black, all black growing up, and I always covered myself up. Black eyeliner and stuff like that. But if you see my sister, you're going to be like...
2.0, huh?
You know how they be having their head to the side type? And they, that little cut?
Yeah.
That's my sister, and she black.
Yeah.
How you even get your hair like that?
Hey, man. Look here, man. That's creative.
I don't know. Like, that just... I don't know. Always been a little different. I never liked the match, and my mom used to be like, you don't look right. I always liked it. I wear all black with some red shoes, and they'd be like, you mismatching.
Right.
I don't think I'm mismatching. And I used to watch the Kardashians since I was a kid.
Mm-hmm.
Too young watching the Kardashians, but I liked it fashion.
Okay.
I'm really into fashion as well, so.
you spoke about that earlier about creating clothing.
Yeah.
Well, tell us a little bit about that.
Well, when I was like 10 years old, I used to just draw out my own designs and stuff like that. So I'm still doing that until I find like somebody who can. Because honestly, I'm like the person who, I do the work, but I actually need somebody to do the work.
I got you.
Like type shit. I'm coming with the money and the designs. And you just bring my shit to life.
Right.
Type shit.
Right.
So once I find, I forgot what they call me.
A designer?
Yeah, but the man told me that I have to find somebody who, you know, they cut out the fabric and they put it on like
seamstress.
Yeah, I don't know what they call, but I had found somebody, but they wanted my whole packet, and I'm real skeptical about that because my mama threw away all my shit. So I'm like, hell,
I'd rather give you one. Let's work on one at a time. Yeah, exactly.
I need to sit with you while you do this because all you're doing is getting a little cardboard and tracing out my
your design. Right. That's pretty dope, though. So that's what you want to do. You want to dabble in that as well.
Yeah, I want to do all that. I also, you know, I take care of the homeless.
You
I
do.
I don't speak on it, but, you know what I'm saying? Because I don't want nobody, like, mentally stopping me from what I'm doing.
Okay.
So, like, on my birthday, like, I was like, it's my birthday, but I should give back to the people. So I just,
what do you do? What are some things you do for
the
homeless?
On the 4th of every month, I just feed the homeless. I go around, drive around. If I see like homeless people, and like right by my house, we got Chesterberg.
Okay, Chesterberg
Park. They be out there. I mean, I just
go out there and feed them.
That's amazing. I got the clothing that I'm not wearing no more, and I give it to the people.
That's amazing. You familiar with Community Love Seed? She been on my platform. That's what she does. So you ever see the refrigerators in the corner store? There'd be a refrigerator sitting.
Yeah.
That's her. Community Love Seed. So she stock them up once a week, and people come eat out of them.
Oh,
and
then she'll stock them up again.
That's where she put that. That's hers. Community Love Seed. Shout out to Community Love Seed, man. I fuck
Shout
with
out.
You. Yeah, man. Definitely. And she take donations as well. So if you got clothing you want to get rid of, you give it to her. She'll make sure you do it in the right place. She's a dope chick, too, man. Man, you connected to something. That says a lot about you, man. You're a lot more than music.
Yeah,
I would say that. A lot more than music, man. You just love to do music, but you're a lot more than music.
Yeah.
Damn, that's so dope, man. I'm gonna ask you, would you mind doing a song or two for me before you leave?
Of course.
Man, I'm looking forward to this, man. I'm happier than a damn, let me not say that. That'd be bad out there. Anyway, this is the Chop Up. I want Fat Man in the building with Magnificent T-Baby. T-Baby, how they can find you, man?
IG Magnificent _ T-Baby. I'm on all platforms. Twitter, HWD _ T-Baby. Snapchat, I'm gonna be on Snapchat, so you gotta follow me on that. Don't worry about Facebook.
Straight up.
Go ahead and Instagram, Magnificent _ T-Baby.
Y'all heard her, man. She came and blessed me with an interview. Real good. This Fat Man. Chop Up Hour, Magnificent T-Baby. Y'all definitely go check out a dope artist, man. She slept on, man. She's a dope artist, man. Y'all go fuck with her, man. Chop Up Hour, Fat Man. Yo.
This the Chop Up Hour. 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 This the Chop Up Hour.